Hello and welcome to Sujith Talks. My name is Sujith Billa, registered migration agent here in Melbourne. This video is about the state nomination occupation lists for ICT professionals and some of those occupations which are not skills assessment ready, which means ACS is not ready to do skills assessment for those occupations. These are emerging occupations just like user experience and cybersecurity occupations that are part of ANSCO 2022, which is not adapted by ACS. And ABS is currently reviewing ANSCO definitions, which means that we will get to see more emerging occupations be ready for skills assessment in the year 2024 before Christmas. You're looking at 1 year from now. But now the situation is some state nomination bodies on their websites are having these occupations which are good for them for 190, 491 purposes, but ACS is not doing skills assessment. So in such cases, you got to reach out to state nomination bodies if you have any confusion about that, but not to ACS because ACS is not doing skills assessment and ABS is not the skills assessment authority. So the body that you got to reach is the state nomination body. And if you observe carefully, there are instructions very clearly sometimes where they will say that this occupation is not ready for skills assessment. In such cases, you got to pick another occupation from the occupation group and get that skills assessment done to be eligible for this occupation, which is not ready for skills assessment. So there's no need to get confused. There is no need to panic and there is no need to wait for the skilled occupation list because we're not getting the new skilled occupation list anytime sooner. There are discussions about an occupation list called as a core skilled occupation list, CSOL, and a reformed test that's going to be in place next year, 2024. The timing of it is not yet disclosed, but you can wait as long as you can because you have no other option. In fact, the timeline is before Christmas. So I am not saying to wait as long as you can, but to be prepared that it won't be coming very soon. There are some exceptions for emerging occupations which are not in the occupation list for visa types such as work visas. And there will be a new subclass for work visas very soon. For example, as an applicant, if you're earning 135,000 and more, even though if the occupation is not in the skilled occupation list, you can still get that visa. It's yet to be seen whether those visas still need ACS skills assessment or not. Even though if they are not in the skilled occupation list, doesn't mean that they do not need skills assessment. So we will get to see all such news next year. And we will also get to see if this core skilled occupation list applies for the points tested visas. And we will also see if the points tested visas remain as they are or will they get a new subclass number. Currently, we got 189, 190 and 491. But the migration strategy released a couple of weeks ago is talking about bringing the number of subclasses down. So the bottom line in this video is if an occupation is on a state nomination body's website, but ACS is not currently assessing it, there is no need to panic. Just follow the instructions of the state nomination body. Thanks for watching this video. If you're after skills assessment for any ICT occupation that currently ACS is doing or will do in the future, reach out to me by going to my website, sujithtalks.au, and book an initial consultation session. Then we can discuss about me advising you as an applicant or assisting you as an applicant in submission of your application. If you want general and free information about ACS skills assessment, subscribe to my YouTube channel, Sujith Talks, and click on the bell icon to get notified. Follow me on LinkedIn, Instagram, and also Facebook, where I've got a group called ACS Skills Assessment for Australian PR. Thanks for watching. Once again, my name is Sujith Billa, registered migration agent here in Melbourne. Thank you. Thank you.